I just posted this comment on my profile just a little while ago. Take the time to read it. Even pause the video if you have to. Okay, that's enough pausing. Alright, if you couldn't read that comment, I am in quite a big snowstorm. I really don't know if you can see by this video, but I'm probably going to brighten it up later. But take a look at the trees over there. Oh man, it's going out of focus because it's so dark out. I mean, it's slightly light out because it's snowing. It just happens that way when it snows. Snow reflects the light, and I don't know if you can see, but the snow is so heavy and so wet that it is coating the trees. Even the thinnest of limbs on the trees are getting a coat of snow. Just look at that! Yeah, I'm definitely have to brighten this video up later in like Windows Movie Maker or something. So, my power is also flickering on and off, so I don't feel really in the mood to be doing anything like computer-wise or gaming-wise, but I do feel like doing something random for some reason. I don't know why. So, let's do something random. Where do I get random ideas from? Look around your home, they're everywhere. Oh my god, I'm getting dizzy. Uh-oh, do you know what time it is? I don't, because the power went out. I don't want to set the clocks, you know, again, because if the power goes out again, I'll just have to set the clocks again. Snowstorm is like, yeah, you just set your clocks, but I'll just make the power go out again. Ha ha, you have to set it all over again. Tee-hee. Same goes if you're like playing a game or something, and yeah, and you don't save, and then the power goes out, and you lost all your progress. If you have one of these clocks that set themselves by satellite, you won't have any trouble of setting them yourself. Which is kind of like the standard now, actually, because they all seem like set that way. Cell phones, clocks like this. But not the microwave! Why, microwave? Why must you make me set you? For some reason, our flat top stove here is this clock right here. For some reason, when the power goes off really quickly and goes back on really quickly, you know, just like flickers on and off, it doesn't reset like the other clocks in the house. It stays the correct time. It's like it's satellite programmed, but it's actually not. This is like the god of all stoves. All hail the stove.
Hail the great and almighty stove!
Battery-operated clocks continue going until their batteries run out. Always make sure your favorite handheld systems are charging in case the power does go out for good. You do not want to be left out in the gaming cold. Ah, she is beautiful. The time is evidently 22:25 according to my DS clock here. That relates to about 10:25. So there's your time when I'm doing this video and when I want to feel random. I don't know, but as you see, it is very hard to film a DS screen steady, let alone try and film both screens at once. I have the camera on macro. Super macro, and it's still hard to see these screens and to keep the DS steady if I wanted to play it. This is why I can't do DS walkthroughs! And DS emulators suck at the moment right now. Well, I shouldn't say they suck, they're just unfinished. People keep working on them, and yeah. So that's why I can't do DS walkthroughs, to the people who are wondering. Golf Digest. 10 tips Obama can take from Tiger. My god, I hope Tiger's not giving Obama marital advice. Aww, too soon? Bertolli, extra virgin olive oil! We all know that Princess Peach doesn't use any of this! Do you know what temperature it is by you? I know what mine is. It's 37. I just realized I forgot to change that clock forward. Dang it! Dang you, daylight savings time! Have you been a good little boy or girl for Christmas? I seriously hope you have, because Santa'll cut you. He'll cut you, man. He'll cut you good. You better be a good boy or girl. You'd better. My god. Look at this Christmas decoration. This is not kid-friendly. Who would buy such a thing? Why do I have this? Okay, going out the front door, listen to this. Yeah, it's pretty bad outside. If you didn't notice when I was opening the door there, the wind is tremendous out here. Look at over by the street light over there. Ah! I'm gonna try and zoom in as far as I can. Focus! You gonna ever focus? You aren't gonna focus, are you? I think it's because that tree is in the way. That tree that's right in front of me here, but I'm not stepping out into that. Oh, geez, snow is getting on the camera. I'm not stepping out into that stuff. Remember I said it was really, really heavy stuff? Look at this. See on the bushes here? See those little tippy tops? Like right on there, the snow is collecting on the edges of the bushes like that. And that's how it's doing. It's doing that absolutely everywhere. On these trees, the trees over here, the trees are everywhere, and it's dangerous. And it's also very cold, and I'm wearing shorts like a madman. But at least I'm wearing a coat, which I don't know if that really matters all that much when it's so windy. And I'm getting pelted with snow, and so is the camera, so I should probably go in. This wasn't that good of an idea. Oh yeah, might as well show the snow. Yeah, it's this kind of packing stuff that you can, yeah, it's really, really hard, wet, so it really sticks to everything. Oh yeah, check this out. These are the shoes that I was wearing outside. These are very non-waterproof shoes anymore. I completely wore these things out. Let's look at the other. Yeah, look at these soles. Look at these soles bend back. I use these pretty much for work and dirty work purposes. Yeah, I have a better pair. These black Nikes. Yeah, okay, they're a little bit dirty, but they're a lot better shape than the other ones. Much, much better shape Nike Force, by the way.
What do you do when the power's out? You tell scary stories.
Oh, dang it, I forgot to turn off the nightlight. God!
What do you do when the power goes out? You tell scary stories. One night, a mother sent her son to the store alone. A blizzard was coming. The son had to hurry. He made it to the store.
Wait, what was the next line?
Oh, right. He made it to the store and got the bread that he was supposed to get. Wait. Forgot to mention that she wanted him to get bread. Dang it! Anyway, the kid got the bread from the store. He walked home. The blizzard started. It was whiteout conditions.
My God, this flashlight is hot.
Anyway, it was whiteout conditions. Somehow. After 4 hours, the son made it home alive. Then, when the mom checked over the loaf of bread that the son got, it was moldy!
What? That's not scary? Why isn't that scary? It's kind of scary to me. I mean, I want peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
It's peanut butter jelly time, peanut butter jelly time. Where ya? Where ya? Where ya? Where ya? There you go. There.
Hope you enjoyed this video, everyone. Bye-bye.